We want to divide the degree 3 polynomial by the degree 1 binomial using long division. And since a fraction bar represents division, we can rewrite this as x cubed plus 8x squared minus 17x minus 15 divided by x plus 3. Now, this is called the dividend, and all these terms must be in descending order, meaning from the highest degree down to the lowest degree. Notice how we have a degree 3 term, a degree 2 term, degree 1 term, and a degree 0 term. If any of these terms were missing, we would put in a placeholder by putting in a 0 term, which I'll show on the next video. Now, to get this process started, we're only concerned about the first term of the dividend and the first term of the divisor. And there are two ways to find the first term of our quotient, or the answer. We can ask ourselves, what times this x would give us x cubed? If we can answer that question and know that it's going to be x squared, that would be the first term in our quotient here. If we're not able to do this, this is a division problem, so we can take x cubed and divide by x. Notice when we do this, x cubed divided by x would be x squared, our first term. Now we're going to multiply x squared and our divisor and put it below. So x squared times x would be x cubed, and then x squared times 3 would be 3x squared, so we have plus 3x squared. And then when performing long division, we need to subtract this result, but instead of subtracting, it's going to be easier if we add the opposite. So we can change this to addition as long as we change the sign of both terms inside the parentheses. So we'll change this to plus, change this to negative x cubed, and change this to negative 3x squared. And now we'll add. Notice how the x cubed terms are opposites. That would be 0. And then we have 8x squared plus negative 3x squared. That would be 5x squared. Bring down the next term, which is minus 17x. And now we're only concerned about the first term of the divisor and the first term of this result. So again, we can ask ourselves, what times this x would be equal to 5x squared? If we know that would be 5x, we can go ahead and put plus 5x up here as our next term. Or we can also take 5x squared and divide by x, which would also equal 5x, our next term. And now we'll find the product of 5x and x plus 3. 5x times x would be 5x squared. And then 5x times 3 would be 15x, so we have plus 15x. And now we need to subtract, but instead we're going to add the opposite. This becomes plus, this becomes negative, and this becomes negative. The x squared terms are opposites. This sum would be 0. And we have negative 17x plus negative 15x. That's going to be negative 32x. Bring down the next term. So now we're only concerned about the first term of the divisor and this first term. And now we can ask, what times x would be equal to negative 32x? So the next term is minus 32. Or we could take negative 32x and divide by x to get negative 32. Now we're going to multiply negative 32 in the divisor, so we'll have negative 32x, then negative 32 times positive 3 is going to be negative 96. And we're going to subtract this result by adding the opposite. So change the sign here, change the sign here, and change the sign here. So the x terms are opposites, and then we have negative 15 plus 96. That's going to be positive 81. We've used all the terms, so this is our remainder. And since the remainder is positive, we'll write this as plus the remainder, 81, over our divisor of x plus 3. So this would be our quotient. And since we have a remainder, we know that x plus 3 does not divide evenly into our polynomial, and therefore x plus 3 is not a factor of the polynomial. One more thing I'd like to mention. Notice how we had a degree 3 polynomial, and we divided by a degree 1 binomial. Notice that 3 minus 1 is equal to 2. which is the degree of our quotient. We'll be looking at another example in the next video.